Alright guys, welcome back to the channel. आज मेरे साथ है हरीश, who is a third year Bits Goa student, and he has a really cool channel by the name of Curious Harish. वहाँ पे वो डालता है काफी cool videos related to coding, related to productivity, related to freelancing. So you can go and check out his channel. Link will be in the description. And आज का video जो है वो हम बनाने वाले हैं freelancing पे. Title से आपको पता ही लग गया होगा कि we'll talk about freelancing, कैसे start करनी चाहिए, क्या-क्या options होते हैं freelancing के, and how to build a sustainable career out of it. That's the big question. क्योंकि जब भी लोग freelancing start करते हैं, mostly वो students होते हैं. Students काफी ज़्यादा interested होते हैं इस चीज़ में, and वो शुरू करते हैं इसको as a side profession, right? Passive income थोड़ी जनरेट हो जाएगी, पॉकेट मनी खुद मैनेज कर लेंगे, वही सब. तो जानते हैं हरीश से कि कैन वी बिल्ड अ सस्टेनेबल इनकम आउट ऑफ इट, एंड क्या हमें स्टार्टिंग में सही करना चाहिए. तो हरीश, वेलकम टू द चैनल एंड थैंक यू फॉर गिविंग मी योर टाइम.
थैंक्स आयुष, प्लेजर बीइंग विद द चैनल.
सो हरीश, डायरेक्टली क्वेश्चन पे आते हैं कि व्हाट आर द प्रीरिक्विजिट्स ऑफ फ्रीलांसिंग. लाइक फ्रीलांसिंग स्टार्ट करने से पहले एक स्टूडेंट को या फिर एक प्रोफेशनल को क्या आना चाहिए.
So in the freelancing space, there are two aspects, the supply part, which is your skill, the thing that you're providing to the client, and then the demand part, how do you find clients? So let's talk about the supply part. You need to learn a skill. Now, this skill could be anything. Graphic design could be building websites, building apps, or doing UI, UX design. Now, how do you figure out what skill you want to explore? The first thing is just see what all these skills are about. There's a book by Varun Maya called Pajama Profit. It has all the skills listed. So read that book, see which one actually interests you. And then once you pick up that skill, see how you can use that skill to benefit a business. Because this B2B space, when you're selling to other businesses, there are three ways to help other businesses succeed. Ek hai, you're helping them save time. So agar they're spending hours and hours kisi unproductive cheez mein, which can be easily outsourced, toh they'll be ready to hire you, right? So jaise DirectIK founder Bhavin, he says that even like choosing his t-shirt, he has outsourced even that work to someone. He pays them to do that. Like, he doesn't want to make that decision. So aise bahut sare companies rehte hain which do not want to do repetitive tasks. It's very unproductive for them. So they can outsource their work to you. There's a company called Pepper Content, which is a freelancing marketplace, which takes outsourced content writing. So ye baki jo companies rehte hain, they can't hire a content writer. It's unko salary pay karke zyada fayda nahi hai. So they just outsource all of their content writing work, like writing blogs, writing copies for their websites. Sab kuch they outsource to Pepper Content, and Pepper Content makes quite a lot of money, but just writing content. So find some skill which helps save someone's time, or find some skill which helps them make more money. So see how can you help them make more money. For example, if you're good at running Facebook ads or Google ads, then that's something that can give them more exposure to a large variety of clients and can in return give them more revenue. So you're helping them make more money. And if, say, you're helping them make like an additional crore, then giving 10% of their profit, say 10 lakhs to you, would not be an issue for them because they're anyway making a lot of money. The third way is helping them save money. So say, they're spending a lot of money in customer support, right? So if agar unke paas 5 customer support sales reps hai who are just just staying on the keyboard helping the customers out navigate the product, if you can help them build a chatbot which automates like 50% of their task, or agar 5 employees ki jagah they can do the work for 2 employees, so you're helping them save a lot of money, right? So that's also a good way of helping these guys out. So agar aapke paas koi skill hai which can do all these 3 things, or one of these 3 things, then that's the perfect way of going about. So jab pitch bhi karoge client ko, you'll have to pitch using these 3 tactics. Aise mat bolo ki acha mujhe paise chahiye, main ye karunga. Be like, this is how I can benefit you, this is how much you can save, or this is how much you can make, or this is how many hours you can save, and therefore hire me. So if you think about it quantitatively, unko benefit karne ke hisab se, then the chance of conversion will be really high. Now let's take a look at the second part, which is the demand part, right? How do you find clients? Now, there are multiple ways of finding clients. You have these freelancing platforms like Upwork, Freelancer, but I don't really recommend them. And then you have personal connections, you have LinkedIn, cold emails, cold calls, attending conferences, or reaching out to companies using other agencies or collaborating with other freelancers, things like that. And I would recommend the second part, which involves building a network with people, right? So jo already freelancing space mein hai, try getting in touch with them, try getting in touch with agencies or development agencies which are already doing this. because the thing is ki jo freelancing space hai, it's all about trust and credibility. So if you're a newbie just getting started, no one's going to trust you. So it's always better if you try getting a taste of the ecosystem. If you're already involved in the ecosystem, baat karo bahut logo se, talk to business owners, see what problems they are facing and how you can contribute to solve them. So I think that will be the ideal way. Try talking to as many people as possible in that ecosystem, and then eventually you'll find out what's the best way of going about. For example, when I started off, I did graphic design for book cover. I did graphic design for authors in Los Angeles. And the reason why I was able to do that was because I knew people who knew authors. So I knew what problems authors were facing. They weren't able to make good book covers, and therefore I was trying to solve that problem. So I would say just stay involved in the ecosystem and that will benefit.
Exactly. And काफी ज़्यादा saturate हो चुका है, you know, freelancing environment अभी काफी ज़्यादा saturate हो चुका है. So it's more about trust and credibility. Clients जो reviews देख के देते हैं, इसलिए reviews इतने ज़्यादा important होते हैं on freelancing websites. तो ये मेरा अगला question था कि हम कहाँ ढूंढ सकते हैं freelancing काम. तो आपने वो बता दिया कि we should cold email या फिर हम लोगों से connect होना चाहिए on be it on LinkedIn, be it on network का network. You should explore that. But I wanted to know कि approach तो हमें client तो पता है कि हमें किसे approach करना है, but how do we approach them? Like कई लोग hesitate करते हैं कि मेरा bid message या फिर मेरा जो email है वो perfect है कि नहीं. तो how does a perfect email look like?
So I'll give you an example. There's a person called Raj Kunkolenikar. He's the founder of Stoa School. He has made a video on how to write good cold emails, so check it out. But the essence of it is that every time you write an email, you need to provide value, because if they are going to give you money, you have to give them something, right? It's a mutual distribution. So what he did was, while he was approaching Gagan Biyani. He wanted to invite him for a talk. Gagan Biyani is the founder of Udemy, right? Now he's a big shot. Aise emails ko reply nahi karenge wo. So what he did was, Gagan Biyani is starting a new startup which allows creators to build courses. And Raj cold emailed him saying, dude, here's a list of 1,000 YouTubers you can approach, and this will help you, you know, reach out to these creators and help them, help you in your new startup. And Gagan Biyani responded to that, hey, thanks for this, how can I help you? So you need to somehow provide value, you need to solve a problem that they are facing, right? So, you know, it could be, say you're a web developer, you can take some screenshots, you can take some performance reviews saying, hey, your website is too slow, I can help you improve it. Or maybe, hey, this design is not responsive enough, I can help you improve the mobile version of it. 70% of your users come on mobile, so why don't you just improve it? So I would say keep trying to solve a problem will be much, much better than just saying, I provide this service, please take me. So I would say try providing some sort of value, and in exchange they might help you in. And also the thing is ki try building long term relationships, right? Jaise pehle isme paise ki baat mat karo, try consulting them, try talking to them, try giving them some advice, and then eventually you can tell them about your services. So you know, right in the first pitch, don't start talking about money. Try giving them some value, try helping them out, and then eventually you can tell them about your services.
Exactly. And aapne kafi dekha hoga ki jab aap freelancing project pe bid karte ho, tab आपको एक बार अगर ये एक्सपीरियंस करना है तो मैं कहूँगा कि अपना एक प्रोजेक्ट डालो फ्रीलांसर पे एंड इनवाइट बिड्स ऑन दैट. आप देखोगे कि काफ़ी लोग बस कॉपी पेस्ट करके बिड्स डाल देते हैं, बिड मैसेज डाल देते हैं, लेकिन द वंस दैट रियली मैटर, जस्ट जो आपकी अटेंशन लेगा, जो अटेंशन सीक करेगा, वो होगा जो कस्टम आपके लिए बिड करा हुआ होगा, जिसने आपकी प्रॉब्लम स्टेटमेंट एक्चुअली पढ़ी होगी एंड फिर उस पर उसने सोल्यूशंस प्रोवाइड करे होंगे, एंड देन यू विल यू नो डिस्कस द प्रॉब्लम विद हिम ऑन द चैट. That is a strategy that has worked for me very well in freelancing, be it on freelancer.com या फिर upwork.com पे भी, and that is what I suppose you should do, because copy paste करना बहुत ज़्यादा आसान है, but किसी की actual problem solve करना, concern show करना काफ़ी ज़्यादा मुश्किल है. And जैसे मैंने आपके बताया, हर्ष ने बताया कि credibility and trust are the most important things, so showing compassion, showing you know that you care about the client is a way of building trust. So हरीश, अब आ जाते हैं कि एक प्रोजेक्ट को, हमें एक प्रोजेक्ट मिल चुका है, बट हाउ डू वी प्राइस इट, लाइक हाउ डू यू इवैल्यूएट कि हमें चार्ज कितना करना चाहिए, क्या हमें $100 चार्ज करने चाहिए, क्या हमें $50 चार्ज करने चाहिए, या फिर हमें सबसे कम बिड करना चाहिए, कि ये स्ट्रैटेजी आजकल काफ़ी चल रही है फ्रीलांसर वेबसाइट्स पे, कि क्या हमें सबसे कम बिड करना चाहिए ताकि बस हमें प्रोजेक्ट मिल जाए.
सो इफ यू आर गुड एट सम स्किल देन डोंट अंडरचार्ज. That's what I would say. A lot of my friends, I think, unka hourly rate is around $20 to $50 an hour. So if you're just getting started, you can start off in the low range. But usually average India mein, this is how much they pay, $20 to $50 an hour. So I would say play in that range. And then here's the thing, right? India mein bahut sare small businesses hote hain, right? People who just have like say a kirana store or say a salon, things that don't earn a lot of revenue, they would obviously not pay you a lot, right? So I would say don't target those kind of businesses. Target businesses which can actually afford your services, businesses that can spend money. A lot of these funded startups, say Y Combinator startups, or you can go to 500 startups, AngelList, Glassdoor, check out the list of all funded startups. They have deeper pockets, they'll be able to spend more. So they'll be ready to give you, I mean, for them, money is not a concern. So over there, you can play with the price. For them, they just want the problem solved. So I would say target that kind of audience, and then money shouldn't really be an issue. You can charge as much as you
want. Exactly. And once you have a repository of products, like aapne kaafi sari website build kar li, tab aap kirana stores pe bhi ja sakte ho ki aapko bas plug and play website provide karni hai. You change. इसे एक चीज़ होती है जो इसे कहते हैं वाइट लिस्टिंग. तो वाइट लिस्टिंग के बारे में पढ़ना, जो आप कुछ तरह की ऐप्स बना लोगे, देन यू कैन स्टार्ट सेलिंग दोज ऐप्स. बस उसको वाइट लिस्ट करना है, उसका जो ब्रांड नेम है वो चेंज करना है, लोगो चेंज करना है, एंड यू कैन पुश इट आउट टू अदर कस्टमर्स एज वेल. तो जब आपका एक थोड़ा एक्सपीरियंस हो जाता है, जब आपको थोड़ा टाइम हो जाता है, इट गेट्स अ लॉट ईजियर. विच ब्रिंग्स मी टू माई अदर क्वेश्चन कि इसको स्केल अप कैसे करें, कि अगर हमें इसे फुल टाइम लेके जाना है तो हमें इसे स्केल अप करना पड़ेगा. हाउ डू वी स्केल अप आवर फ्रीलांसिंग बिजनेस एज एन इंडिविजुअल, उसके बाद हम क्या कर सकते हैं इसके लिए?
तो सिंस इट्स अल्टीमेटली अ सर्विस बेस्ड थिंग, यू नो, इट्स नॉट समथिंग रिपीटेबल. जैसे बायजूस हैज कोर्सेज, दे कैन सेल द सेम कोर्स टू 1000 अदर पीपल, बट यू हैव अ सर्विस. तो आफ्टर अ सर्टेन पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम अकेले मैनेज करना, से 4-5 क्लाइंट्स इज फाइन, बट वंस यू हैव 6th क्लाइंट, उतना मैनेज करना बिकम्स वेरी हार्ड. तो देर आर टू एस्पेक्ट्स. लाइक फर्स्ट थिंग इज कि ये दिस इज नॉट अ fancy startup, right? This is not something which will get funded because it's ultimately just outsourcing work. Secondly, but it's a very good business. So if you want profits, agar dhanda setup karna hai, so this is a really good place to get started with, right? So in that terms, I would say labor in India is very cheap. You'll find developers or you'll find graphic designers at really low rates. So you can start hiring more freelancers under you. This is something that so many people in India do, right? They get like, say, 5 good Australian or American or European clients, really good companies that are earning quite a lot, and then they just set up their base in India. Okay, in Silicon Valley, the price of an engineer is $15,000 per month. Exactly. In India, you can get an engineer for less than $1,000 per month. So they use that price difference, build up, scale up a team. You know, there are so many examples of these free. There was one company called Avalon, they scaled it pretty well. So there are multiple examples of these people who got started with freelancing and then scaled it up as a team, create an agency of sorts. But yeah, so that's one way of scaling it up, creating an agency.
Exactly. आपको यू कैनॉट डू एवरीथिंग ऑन योर ओन, यू हैव टू बिल्ड एन ऑर्ग. एंड मैं आपको एक बहुत अच्छा एग्जांपल दूंगा कि ये जो इन्फोसिस टीसीएस है, ये भी बेसिकली देर आर बिग फ्रीलांसर्स ओनली. इनका जो मेजर क्लाइंट बेस है वो यूएसए एंड यूरोप में है, तो वहाँ से वो प्रोजेक्ट्स उठाते हैं. हाँ, उनके प्रोजेक्ट्स होते हैं 1000 करोड़ के. उनके हमारे तरह 1-2 लाख के प्रोजेक्ट्स नहीं होंगे, उनके हजारों करोड़ों के प्रोजेक्ट्स होते हैं. बट एसेंशियली दे आर डूइंग द सेम थिंग. दे आर बिग फ्रीलांसर्स. दे स्टार्टेड एट द टाइम ऑफ .com बूम एंड नाउ दे आर रनिंग रियली वेल. बट एज एन इंडिविजुअल यू कैन डू दैट. यू कैन, यू नो, बिल्ड योर ओन ऑर्ग एंड देन स्केल दिस थिंग अप. सो हरीश, की मेरा अगला क्वेश्चन ये था कि हाउ मच टाइम वुड इट टेक. लाइक एक होप होती है हर स्टूडेंट के दिमाग में जब वो स्टार्ट करता है कि मेरे को फाइनेंशियली इंडिपेंडेंट होना है, मैं इसमें अपना टाइम इन्वेस्ट कर रहा हूँ, लेकिन कितना टाइम लगेगा कि आई कैन, यू नो, स्टार्ट अर्निंग सस्टेनेबल इनकम?
Well, that more or less depends on what scale, what stage you are in. So if you are someone who already has a skill, or if only finding a client is the concern, then it will take much shorter time. But then if you're a student who has nothing and you just want to earn money, then you'll have to learn the skill and then specialize in it, build some personal projects, and then eventually reach out to clients. So yeah, it depends on from person to person, I would say.
Yeah, I mean, there is no, you know, ki hum 2 saal bol de, 3 saal bol de, it's not fixed answer. Lekin haan, you can earn substantial income from it once you know, get good at what you do. Once aapke paas ek aise clients hain jo ki aapko repeated projects denge. Once you have that, you can, you know, start earning sustainable income from that. So Harish, any closing tips, koi tips ya message hamari audience ke liye?
Yeah. So a lot of people think that they can quit their job and do freelancing full time. I know it sounds very lucrative. You might have seen a lot of people do it, but I would say explore all options, right? See what's the opportunity cost if I do an internship versus freelancing. What if I just go out there and do a job versus, you know, internship versus freelancing? Explore all options. Aise nahi hai ki there is only one fixed path just because someone else did it. So, you know, gauge all these opportunities. Fir dekho ki what suits you the best, right? Because bahut sare log hai who start out with freelancing, they're like, acha, ek client mil gaya, do client mil gaya, abhi mil raha nahi hai. Because it's a very risky game. If you don't have repeatable revenue sources, it's a very risky game. So acknowledge that. It's always, I mean, if you want to play it safe, then I would say do a job or do something that gives you repeatable income and then do this on the side. But if you think that you can scale this up, if you think that you're getting clients who are giving you repeated content as in your repeated projects every single month, then you can maybe take it up full time. But yeah, ultimately gauge all opportunities, sare options test out karo, there's no one fixed path.
And apart from this, मेरे को ये भी लगता है कि when you're a software developer, you should be more connected with the product. क्योंकि the reason that I gave up freelancing was कि I wasn't able to connect with the product in the long term. कि product आगे जाके कैसा use हो रहा है, कैसे उसमें लोग interact कर रहे हैं उससे, उसमें क्या improvements होनी चाहिए, वो मैं नहीं कर पा रहा था. तो that is when I started to think कि मतलब मेरे को इसमें इतना मज़ा नहीं आ रहा है, कोई product से emotional connection नहीं है, and then I gave up freelancing. But yeah, it's everyone has a different choice, has a different taste, so आपको वो evaluate करना होगा. Thank you, Harish, for coming on the channel and sharing your valuable thoughts. So, मैंने आपको बताया कि हरीश का काफी अच्छा चैनल है. He speaks a lot about freelancing, productivity and stuff. अब वो जाके चेक कर सकते हो, डिस्क्रिप्शन में लिंक होगा. टाइटल में भी मैं टैग डाल दूंगा. And yeah, we'll see you next time. Till then, take care.
Thanks, Ayush. Glad.